Hi, this is Josh with Solar Tech TV from Wholesale Solar, and today we're going to talk about one of my favorite subjects, batteries. We're going to take a look at the main types of batteries that are offered by Wholesale Solar, what some of the major differences are, and why someone might choose one over the other. Let's take a look. The umbrella term lead acid battery covers a few different categories, and the most common ones you're going to bump into are going to be flooded, like this guy, absorbed glass mat batteries, like these guys, and to a lesser extent, gel cell batteries. They're all just some combination of lead and sulfuric acid. They're just being used in different ways. Let's look at flooded batteries first. Flooded batteries are definitely going to be the longest lasting and most cost effective lead acid battery available. You're commonly going to find them in an off-grid system. Now keep in mind, they do require maintenance, and they also require an enclosure that's vented to the outside, because the gases they make can be stinky and explosive. Wholesale Solar offers some vented enclosures, or you can build your own. They're required by the NEC, plus they protect your batteries from physical damage, maintain a more consistent temperature, which can extend the life of your battery. It's really easy to identify a flooded lead acid battery because they've got access caps on the top. And what that gives us access to is the sulfuric acid solution inside. Now we want to be sure to add distilled water as needed to replace the liquid that's lost during the charging and discharging process. That's part of your standard maintenance. Also, it's a really good idea to make sure all of your cables are tight and free from corrosion. Absorbed glass mat or AGM batteries are perfect for applications where maintenance is either impossible or just undesired. AGM batteries are sealed. They're non-spillable, and they're also considered to be non-hazardous. AGM batteries can be more deeply discharged. They can be mounted in any orientation that the project calls for, but those conveniences come at a cost. An AGM battery can be upwards of 50% more expensive than a flooded lead acid bank for the same capacity. Gel cell batteries are also considered to be maintenance-free, spill-proof. They're sealed batteries, but they're a little different from an AGM in that the sulfuric acid solution inside is suspended in a jelly. Now, the gel cells aren't ideal for renewable energy applications because they tend to have problems with high amperage charging and discharging. High amperage means high heat. High heat means the gel bubbles. If it bubbles away from the plates, you've got dead spots, and then you're in trouble. You've probably been hearing a lot about lithium batteries recently. And while the technology is absolutely amazing, they're still a lot more expensive than any of the other options. Wholesale Solar is not currently offering lithium batteries, but we're keeping a very close eye on the ever-advancing technology. Which batteries are right for you? The flooded batteries are going to work really well in an off-grid system. They can take a really high amperage charge and discharge. That's really helpful when you're trying to get all your power for a day in 5 hours. They'll work out really well in a grid tie with battery backup situation as well, if you're willing to put in the maintenance on them. AGMs are going to work out really well in a grid tie with battery backup, where you could give them a lot more mellow charge over a longer period of time at a lower amperage. They like that. You could use an AGM in an off-grid system if you wanted to. It just has to be sized really meticulously. And that is the scoop on lead acid batteries. At Wholesale Solar, we know batteries. So if you've got any questions, give us a call or check out the website. This is Josh with Solar Tech TV. Have a great day.
Because the gases they make can be stinky and explosive, and then you're in trouble.